Hey everyone, Off Grid Technology here. Just wanted to give a quick update on this Radiodity GM30 that I purchased from Radiodity. It's a GMRS radio, it's set to the GMRS frequencies, and it's very fairly priced. It's about $40. But since I've had it in the last few weeks, I've noticed a couple quirks with this radio that kind of will throw it off for you. So one of the things I noticed is that the menu settings, when you put those in manually, they will change sometimes. More frequently, the beep and the voice on this one. So I will set the beep off in the settings, and randomly the beep will turn on when just turning on the radio sometimes. And until I go into the menu, it will not turn that beep off. So that is one thing that I don't particularly like about this radio. It does work well. It's a very good radio. It does transmit well, it does receive well. As you see, there's here, as I'm scanning through, there's a lot of settings that you can go through. It's got a lot of features. It does have a removable antenna, despite what everybody says. There's a little Allen key here, right in this little hole, and if you actually put a small enough Allen key in that hole, you can get the antenna off. It looks like it's a female SMA and the antenna is male SMA, so just keep that in mind. Another issue I found with this radio is the battery. The battery on this is hell. I had just charged this battery up yesterday to full, and I pulled it off a few minutes ago off the charger, and you can see it's already, in the video here, it's blinking between a 2 and a 3 bar. So it says it's at 7.2 volts right now. I'm gonna check and see what the cutoff voltage and what the top voltage is as far as the maximum charge, but this thing does not hold the battery very long. You'll notice that as you're using it throughout the day, the battery will decrease quite a bit. So keep that in mind. It is USB-C rechargeable, which is a great thing. Now this USB-C is not data capable. This is only for charging the battery. So if you take the battery off of the unit, you can see that the USB-C is only on the battery. There's nothing that interfaces with the radio. So for the radio, you still need to have the Baofeng style interface cable. And it does have to have the chipset in the cable. You can't use a cable from like an RD5R from Baofeng. That one does not work. So you do have to use an old Baofeng like UV5R style cable. But that's just a quick little update. The battery is the biggest thing for me. That's a deal breaker for me, especially since right now there are no other batteries. Oh, the other thing I wanted to talk about, sorry, is this clip. This clip is hellacious. It is wobbly. It is off center. It gets caught on everything. It is worst clip I've ever had. Please, please, Radiodity, change this clip. So, and just FYI, I am on the latest firmware, so I did download the latest firmware from Radiodity. I failed to forget the version. I will put it in the comments of what the version is, as far as the firmware that I'm running. But the beep is the biggest thing, the battery is the biggest thing, and this clip. Other than that, this radio is solid. I've dropped it several times already on the ground. You can see right there I've dropped it. Right there I've dropped it. It is a very durable radio. It's a very good radio. It works very well. I have no problems with the radio, just a little quirks with the software, as well as the battery. The battery needs to be overhauled. We need a better battery, a better clip, and it would have been nice to see the battery charging the USB-C on the device itself versus the battery. But yeah, little preview for you guys. If you guys want to see anything else, just let me know. Give a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe. I'm fairly new, but I will be putting out a lot more radio content. Especially off-grid radio content. As you can see here, I've got a Midland antenna attached to my truck, which goes to a Midland MXT275 in the truck. I've got some other radios coming. I've got some repeater projects coming. So subscribe, thumbs up if you like it, and I hope this gives you guys a little bit of information. Again, good radio. I would definitely buy it again if they would fix the battery issues, the clip issues, and of course, whatever this software bug is. I wish I could give them more details, but I don't know why it's doing it, but we'll see. Anyway, 73 out, guys. WQXM 648. Have a great one.